Hey everyone, what's up? It's Rob Dotson here from the Google Developer Relations team. And in this video, we're going to be looking at the core toolbar element. Now, I personally think core toolbar is one of the coolest elements out there because it's really handy and it's very easy to master. So let's take a look. So the core toolbar is a really basic container for laying out controls like tabs or buttons. So what I'm doing here is I've got a toolbar element on my page, and I've just put a div inside of it that says my app. And that's going to give me the title of my application up here in the top left. Now, if I want, I can nest additional items inside of here. I could include a core icon button, maybe give it like an icon menu. And that's going to give me this little hamburger menu that you see up here. But the other cool thing that's going to happen is the toolbar is smart enough to know to just scoop my title out of the way. It'll just move it over there horizontally. And I don't need to write any CSS to make this happen, which is pretty handy. Now, the toolbar also comes with some built-in stylings. For instance, if we give it a class of medium tall, you can see that it gets just a little bit bigger. And if we give it a class of tall, it'll get even larger. All right, now there's some really cool things that we can do with these larger toolbars. So let's hop into our terminal. We'll actually install everything using Bower, and we'll use our code editor to show off some of these additional features. So over in our terminal, we're going to use Bower to install the core toolbar. So I'll type bower install. I'll pass the save flag, which is really important, so that way these dependencies get written in my bower JSON file. And then I'm going to ask for polymer core toolbar. I'll ask for polymer paper icon button, which we haven't touched on before, but we'll be demonstrating in this video. I'm also going to ask for the paper progress element, another cool element that we're going to show off today. So that's going to go out and fetch all these different dependencies. And once that's loaded, we can switch over to our code editor. So over here, we've got the basics of an application kind of ready to go. And the first thing we're going to need to do is we're going to include the platform. And that way, we can use web components in browsers that lack support. So I'll say Bower components platform slash platform.js. Now that that's in place, I can go ahead and import the definition for our core toolbar. So I'll say Bower components core toolbar, ask for core toolbar.html. And then I can hop down to my body tag and drop a core toolbar element right there on the page. And inside, we'll just nest a little div, and we'll say my app for the title of our application. Now, some of you may have noticed this full bleed attribute and wondered, like, what's this all about? Well, that's actually one of our layout attributes. And what it's going to do is it's going to make sure that the browser, that the body tag within it, doesn't have any white space around the outside. So our toolbar is going to go right up to the edge of the screen and look really nice. So refresh the page, and what we're going to see is our toolbar showing up, and it's going right up to the edge of the browser, which is really cool. And right now it's kind of this like drab gray color. It's not super exciting to look at. So we can change that by going back into our editor. And we'll just drop in a style sheet. So I'm going to pop open the sidebar in Sublime, create a new file, and I'm just going to call this thing app.css. And over in app.css, write out a style for the core toolbar. So I ask for a core toolbar, set the background color equal to, actually, I got one saved here. I'll just drop that in. And then we'll set the color equal to white for the text. And back in our index file, we got to make sure to include that style sheet so our styles actually show up. Now when we go and refresh the browser, we've got a slightly nicer looking toolbar. It's got a kind of a cool color to it and some white text. But it's still missing controls, so you can't really do much with it. So let's change that. We'll go back to our editor. And we're going to import some more definitions here. We're going to import the definition for that paper icon button that we installed earlier. Now, we haven't really talked about the paper icon button, but we did show the core icon button in one of the previous videos. And you can think of the paper icon button as being basically the same as the core icon button, but it's just got a little bit more pizzazz to it. So I'm also going to be sure to load the definition for the core icons element set. This will just give me the default icons that I can start working with and dropping them into my paper icon button. And then down in my toolbar, I'll include the paper icon button. And I'll configure its icon attribute, and I'll say I want a menu icon. So now when I refresh the page, I get this little hamburger menu over on the left. And when I click on it, you see this sort of like splashy ink effect. That's the cool pizzazz that I was talking about before. Now I want another icon, so I'll just duplicate this line here and I'll add a search icon. And we go back and refresh the page in our browser, and now we've got this magnifying glass over here as well. But the problem is the layout is not exactly what I want. I kind of want the search icon to appear like somewhere over here, like over on the right-hand side of my application. So in our editor, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to give the div a flex attribute. And because the toolbar is using Flexbox to lay out its children, you'll see that now our magnifying glass moves all the way over to the right-hand side of the screen. The title is kind of pushing it over there. Well, that's really cool, but there's a slight problem to this approach. If we open the dev tools and we actually inspect the MyApp element, you can see that it sort of spans this entire distance. And if I made MyApp like a clickable link or something like that, then this whole area in here would be clickable, and we don't really want that. So what we're going to do is, instead of putting the flex attribute on my app, we'll just drop in a span tag, and we'll put the flex attribute on that. And this is kind of a little bit of a trick, but it's pretty handy. And now when we open the dev tools, you'll see that my app is only as big as the content inside of it. And that span tag is basically shimming the space between the title of our app and that magnifying glass. All right, so if you recall at the beginning of the video, I said that there's some really cool features that we get from working with larger toolbars. Now that our toolbars are showing up, we got some controls inside of them, we can actually explore those awesome features. Let's check it out. So over in our code editor, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to add a tall class to our core toolbar. And that's going to give us that much larger toolbar that we showed earlier in the slides. So save this and go and refresh the page, and now we've got this much larger toolbar that we can work with. And now that we've got a bigger toolbar, the interesting thing that we can do is we can actually start pinning these child elements to different locations within the toolbar. So if you look at our code editor, I'm going to hop down to this div tag, and I'm just going to give it a class of bottom. And what that's going to do is it's actually going to jump my app down to the bottom of the toolbar, which is pretty nice. And there's a few other built-in classes. If I want, I can hop back into my editor and bump it up to the middle of the toolbar. Save that and refresh the page. We can also indent the title if we want, just sort of scoot it over a little bit. Now, the other interesting thing that we can do is we can actually fit an item right to the bottom without any sort of like margin or padding or anything. You can imagine loading something like a progress bar down there. And in fact, that's exactly what we're going to do. So hop back into my code editor, and I'm going to import the definition for that paper progress element that we installed before. Now, paper progress is basically just a really simple progress bar. I'm going to clean this up just a little bit so the import looks a bit nicer. And then down here in my core toolbar, I'll drop in the paper progress element. I'll give it a class. We're going to use the bottom class, which you saw before, to move it to the bottom of the screen. But then we'll give it another class. We'll add a fit class, and that's going to remove any margin or padding from the toolbar itself. We'll also give it a value of 30, so you can see that it's kind of partially filled up. And now when I refresh the screen, you'll see that I've got this sort of green toolbar here, and you've kind of got this gray area where it's not filled in. So that's one way that you could add a progress bar to your application, and you could imagine updating that value attribute using something like JavaScript, so you see this thing kind of animating and zipping along as content is loading into the page. So that about covers everything you need to know to work with the core toolbar. It's not a very complex element, and that's kind of the beauty of it. Once you've mastered it, you can just reach forward out of your toolbox the same way that you pull out, you know, div, paragraph, table. In the next video, I'm going to show you how you can incorporate the core toolbar with some other scaffolding elements, and we're going to begin to build what look like the beginnings of mobile applications. So stay tuned for that. Hope to see you there.